Princess is walking me. Okay, calm down. What the heck? She's all excited. I took her just the other day and now she's all hyper again. She has like super hyperness. I don't know if that's the kind of dogs because she's a Cocker Spaniel. These are hunting dogs that they like hunt birds or whatever. I don't know what they hunt, but supposedly they're hunting dogs, but she's got so much energy. I can't keep up with her. She walks me. She's my personal trainer now. Wow. And I'm going to the gym today, you guys. Hallelujah. I'm finally going to pay my gym membership. They said I just have to pay $70 and then, they'll let me work out again. And then I got to pay next month, but I don't have to worry about it right now because I'm just trying to keep my mental sanity from living with some crazy roommates, but it's okay. I'll get through it. I've been bouncing around for a while, bad roommates, bad living conditions, and it'll be okay. I'm just, yeah. So I'm just holding on. Hanging out by a tiny little thread, trying to give my life back to Jesus. You know, sin is fun for a little while, but it doesn't pan out in the long run. You got to like nip it in the bud. You know, God doesn't mind like if you mess up, but then if you keep messing up, then that's when all hell breaks loose. It gets really bad. Especially like, because it says it's a terrible thing to fall into the hands of the living God. It means like, don't play with God. Like, we shouldn't play with God. You know, you play with the devil all you want because he doesn't care. He just wants your soul. But if we play with God, he's going to discipline us because he loves us. So that's the catch-22 about that. And it took me a while to realize as a Christian why I was going through stuff. I was like, I thought being a Christian was a good thing. And, you know, because I was getting blessed too at the same time. But then I was going through trouble too. And then I remember what the Bible says, that you're going to go through some stuff. But once you get through it, then you could go to another level as a Christian.
Look at you. All the dogs are jealous of you because you're going for a walk. And they have to stay in their yard. Oh, doggy princess.
Oh, wow. This is a stress reliever right here. I've been trying to just sleep so I can avoid, you know, dealing with the roommates and all the stuff that they do to the house. Because I was cleaning and cleaning and cleaning. I was exhausting myself like I had a job. And it's like, it's not my job to clean up after other people. Like, I realized that just get rid of the dishes. But I do have to provide, like, you know, dish liquid. I use a lot of that stuff, but I do provide that. And then they've been using my bathroom and my toilet paper and stuff, which is not cool, but I already, you know, I'm surviving it. I don't want people walking around, you know, without wiping their ass. So it's like, yeah, I'll provide it, you know, just for now until I can get the fuck out or they get out. So, yeah, because they were breaking all the rules. I wasn't. And then they were trying to, like, tell on me when I helped them. I'm like, what? They're trying to say that stuff about my dog. And it's like, so what about my dog? I take care of my dog and I clean up after my dog and everything. But Heidi doesn't like my dog or she doesn't like animals. So I was like, I don't know. Because that's what we got in a fight over last time. But I'm still going to help her because she's... Because, you know, I'm not a bad person. I help people. But, you know, sometimes if you help people too much, then that's the problem. You know, you can't, you got to just kind of draw the line where you help, where you keep helping and helping and helping, because then people start to walk all over you.
Hot boogie bear. Hot boogie bear.
Oh, God. I'm going to the gym today, you guys. I got to pick up my work clothes. I got to go back to work. It's like a chaos at the house. I'm like, I'm not dealing with it no more. I just got to get her on some kind of routine or get puppy pads or something, because I'm going to be gone for like 8 hours and stuff. I'm saving my Lyft rides for when I have to get home really quick after my 8-hour shift and then hopefully hustle up some more money.
Huh, boogie, 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 boogie.
Yeah, it's all good in the hood. That was the rant. But I'm surviving.
Doggy surviving. She's been through hell and back with mommy. She's been through a lot, this dog. She's been through like so much, I can't even say. We were living at Motel 6, jumping around and bad roommates and being locked up in a room and all this stuff. And it's just, and then the other roommates, I had to pay them to watch her so that nobody would try to sell her or, you know, or so she wouldn't get out. It's like, geez, I had to pay people just to watch my dog. Cray cray. All right. Well, you guys have a blessed day. We all go through storms and stuff, so we will get through it with Jesus on our side. I'm a firm believer that, you know, it says he gives good gifts to his children, and he does. The only problem is when you know, if you step out of line, then that's when, you know, you're going to face a consequence or something. But I'm really doing good because I got a lot of sleep. I've been resting. I feel so rejuvenated. I feel like so rejuvenated after that rest. I slept all day yesterday. I know when I need sleep. And today is a motivational day for me because I got enough rest. Like, share, and subscribe. Shall Ramon.